Welcome to the class, students. So today we are going to start the chapter number 4, that is Animal Kingdom. In the previous classes, we studied that R.H. Whittaker, the famous scientist, he classified all the living organisms into the 5 kingdoms. The first one was Monera, second Protista, third Fungi, fourth Plantae, and the fifth one is Animalia. We already discussed the 4 kingdoms. So now it's the turn of fifth kingdom, that is Animal Kingdom, that also named as Animalia. It comprises the multicellular eukaryotic organisms that do not possess a cell wall. As you all know, in animal, cell wall is absent, right? And it comprises multicellular. That means in animal kingdom, all the organisms are made up of many cells. Multi means many and cellular means cell. That means many cell organisms. And all the organisms are eukaryotic. What do you mean by eukaryotic? Eukaryotic means those organisms which are having the true well-defined nucleus. Eukaryotic word is made up of two, eu and karyotic. Eu means true, karyotic karyote, that means the true nucleus. Okay. So what are the bases of classification? As you all know, there is a diverse variety of organisms in Animalia. So we can't study each and every organism. So therefore, there is need to classify the organisms. But before classification, it's more important than on which basis we are classifying it. So the first one is the level of organization. That means their body is made up of cell, cellular level, tissue level. What is tissue level? When the cells combine and perform a particular function, that is the group of cells which are attaining and performing a particular function is named as tissue. So tissue is the advanced level of organism as compared to cell. After tissue, organs. That means organs start forming in those organisms. And after organ, the organ system, the last level, the advanced one. For example, in humans, we are having the organ system level of organization. For example, in digestive system, many organs are responsible. Stomach, liver, many organs are there which are involved in only one function, that is for digestion. So this is the first level. The second one is pattern of organ system. Now, what do you mean by the pattern? As you all know, the first system is digestive system. Digestive system is can be incomplete or complete. Now, how on which basis we can say it's having the incomplete digestive system or complete? That depends on the alimentary canal. As you all know, alimentary canal consists of many parts. The first one is mouth. Second, buccal cavity. Third, pharynx. Fourth, esophagus, that is also named as food pipe. The fifth one is stomach. Sixth, small intestine. And the seventh one is large intestine. And the last one is anus. So the organism which is having both the openings, which is having the mouth as well as anus, both the openings are there. As you know, mouth is for intake of food and anus is for the removal of undigested food products, right? So the organism which are having both the openings, they are having the complete digestive system. And if one opening is missing, either the mouth or anus, then those organisms are having the incomplete digestive system, as it's written here. The second one is circulatory system. Now, circulatory system is responsible for the transportation of blood, right? So, circulatory system is for two types, the open one and the closed one. Now, what do you mean by open and closed? As you all know, the blood flows in the blood vessels. Right? Blood vessels means arteries, veins, and capillaries. In some organisms, blood vessels are not present and blood is pumped out from heart and cells and tissue and directly bathed into it. That means without any tubes in the complete body, the blood circulated. Those organisms are having the complete circulatory system, and if the complete blood vessels, arteries, veins, and capillaries are present, those organisms are having closed circulatory system. The next one is blood symmetry, body symmetry. Now, what do you mean body symmetry? That means their body is symmetrical or not. The first one is bilateral symmetry. bilateral symmetry kya hoti hai? That is, can be divided into equal halves by only one plane. For example, in humans, if we will cut it from our center longitudinally, from head to the foot portion, from the center one, then one eye on the one side, one ear on the one side, second one will on different side. That means by only one plane, we can divide the complete organism into two equal parts. That is bilateral symmetry. Second is radial symmetry. Radial symmetry is found in the lower one, as you can see in the starfish. In the starfish, if you will cut it from this side, it's again divided into two equal parts. If you cut by this, it's again divided into equal parts. If you cut the organism from this plane, still the organism can divide into two equal parts. So that means the organism can divide to in equal parts by any plane. Many planes are there through which we can divide the organism into two equal parts. So that type of symmetry is known as radial symmetry. Now the third one is asymmetrical. A means always using the absent one, the negative one. That means the body is not divided into equal halves. Their body is so irregular that we can't distinguish into two equal parts by any plane. Okay. So the next, here you can see the first figure. These are asymmetrical one. The second one is radial symmetry. As you can see, this is the first plane, right? This is the second one by which we can divide, and this plane, this line, this is the third plane. So three planes are there through which we are dividing the organism into two equal parts. Here you can see only one plane is responsible for dividing the organism into two equal parts. So this one is the bilateral symmetry. The next phase is body cavity. Body cavity, cavity means the empty space. Okay. So here are the first one is coelomates. Coelomates, a word I told you that used in the negative sense, and coelom means body cavity. That means no body cavity. As you can see here, the flatworms, they are not having any proper body cavity. Second one is coelomates. Coelomates means the true body cavity. That is also named as eucoelomates. As I told you, U word, EU, U word is always used for the true one. Okay. So many organisms comes under this category. And the third one is pseudocoelomates. Pseudocoelomates means false body cavity. It looks like that the body cavity is there, but it is not completely formed. Okay. The next one is germ layers. Germ layers means those layers through which the different parts of the body formed. So here the organisms are classified into two categories, the diploblastic and triploblastic. Diploblastic, di means always used for the di, mono means one, di means two. So here, triploblastic, tri means three. So here the diploblastic means organisms having the two germ layers. Which two germ layers? Ectoderm and endoderm. Now ectoderm is the outer one. Ectoderm होती है आपकी जो outer layer होती है, and endoderm that is the inner layer. Okay, which is present inside. Okay. Now the triploblastic, they are having the three germ layers: ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. Ectoderm is outer one. The new one is mesoderm, that is in the middle one. Okay. If you will start from the outer portion, as you can see in this figure too. Here you can see the ectoderm is the outer one, this blue colored. The second one is mesoderm, this orange color, and endoderm is in the center, the green color one. Okay. So by this you can identify these are the germ layers through which the different organs develop at the time of formation of organism. Okay. So now the next one, here is the figure also, the diploblastic and triploblastic. In diploblastic, as you can see, endoderm and ectoderm are there. There is no mesoderm. In triploblastic, mesoderm is also there. So these all are the bases by which we can classify the organisms. Here is a flow chart by which we can divide the organisms into different phyla. As you all know, there is a taxonomical hierarchical series, right? The kingdom, phylum, I'm mentioning here. Taxonomy, hierarchy. Okay. The first one is kingdom. Second one is phylum. Third, lower than this, class. Fourth, order. Fifth, family. Sixth, genus. and the seventh word is species. So this is a series: the kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. These seven are the hierarchical series. Okay. Kingdom is the advanced one. We studied this series in the first and the second chapter. Okay. So here we also studied the different level of organization, right? So first level of organization is cellular, tissue, organ, and organ system. The first level, the cellular level. In this, the first phylum is there, that is named as Porifera. Okay. The second phylum, which comes under the second level of organization, that is tissue, organ, and organ system. So this is the first category on which we are classifying the organism, that is level of organization. So advanced one is tissue, so it will be further bifurcated. But the cellular one, in this the first phylum is there, that is Porifera. Okay. In tissue and organ, the second level on which we are dividing is symmetry. Symmetry means dividing the organism into two equal parts. The first one is radial and the second one is bilateral. Radial means by any plane you can divide the organism into two equal parts. Starfish, I have given the example. So here are two phyla, the Colentrata, that is also named as Cnidaria, and the third one is Ctenophore. Okay. The second category is the bilateral one, right? Now on the basis of body cavity of or cilium, it classifies the organism into three. The first one is without body cavity. For cavity, we use the word cilium, right? And for the negative one, a word is used. So the organism which are not having the body cavity, they are named as acoelomates. In acoelomates, the first one phylum is there, that is Platyhelminthes, the also named as flatworms. Okay. The second one is the with false body cavity, which is named as pseudocoelom, and the organisms are named as pseudocoelomates. In this, the fifth phylum will be there, that is Ascalminthes, right? And in the true coelom, that is the true body cavity, which is also named as eucoelomates. In this, these six are there: Annelida, Mollusca, Arthropoda, Echinodermata, Hemichordata, and Chordata. That's about the classification of Animalia. Okay. Now, one by one, we have to study about all these phylum. So today we will study the Porifera, the first one. This is the Porifera one. Porifera. What is the meaning of Porifera? Porifera means the pore-bearing animal. That means the organism which is having the pores on all over the body. As you can see in this figure, in all the organisms, the first one, Leucosolenia, Spongia, Sypha, Euplectella, all the organisms are having the pores on over body, the complete body, the pores are there. And the pores are named as ostium. As you can see here, the ostium or the pores name you can use. Okay, so the members of this phylum are commonly known as sponges, like a sponge. This is sponge hoti hai, isme bahut sare holes hote hain. Theek hai, the same way the sponge, the normal sponge hum ghar mein bhi use karte hain, hamare furnitures mein bhi use hoti hai. Theek hai, wo sponge. So mostly ye kya hote hain, marine hai. Marine means they are the aquatic one. Asymmetrical because they are not having the true differentiation. We can't divide the organism into two equal parts and have cellular level of organization, that is the basic level. The second one is they have a water transport or canal system. Okay, now how, through which the water travels? This is the question. As you can see in the figure, this opening is there, right? Ostia is there and as well as osculum is there. Ostium is the opening, right? And osculum is this opening, right? So ostia are the minute pores, the small pores which is present all over the body, right? And from where it goes out through osculum. So through ostium, the water enters in the body, right? And after entering in the body, the extra water removed out through osculum. Okay. The ostia, जो आपके minute pores है वहां से जो body है, क्योंकि marine water है, marine में रहते हैं, यानी कि aquatic में रहते हैं. Aquatic में है तो आसपास क्या होगा, सर? Water होगा. Water can enter through ostium and the removal of water occurs through osculum. Okay. After that, the next functions: nutrition, respiration, and excretion. Nutrition means the mode of intake of food. Respiration means the breakdown of food in the presence or absence of oxygen or the gases exchange. Excretion is the removal of waste. These all processes occur by the water transport system because they are not having the well-defined. There are no particular organs. As you all know, they are having the cellular level of organization. So there is no organ, no tissue for the different functions. So by water transport system, these all functions performed. Next, the skeleton. Skeleton means the structure that is made up of spicules or spongin fibers. Here the egg and the sperm, these are the male and female gametes. They are produced by the same organism. That means they are hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means those organisms which are having both the organs, the male as well as female. Hermaphrodite, which is having the male as well as female part. So these type of organisms are also named as bisexual. That means organism is having both in one organism, and also named as monoecious. Okay, hermaphrodite, bisexual and monoecious, these all are the names which are used for these type of organisms which is having the male as well as female part. Okay, and they mainly reproduce by the method of fragmentation. Now what do you mean by fragmentation? Fragmentation means the organism is divided into parts and each part will form the complete organism. If this is the organism, ये आपका ऑर्गेनिज्म था, ठीक है? This is the organism. ये इसकी एक आई थी, ये दूसरी. If it bifurcate, अगर ये यहाँ से डिवाइड हो गया तीन पार्ट्स में, ठीक है? तो जो फर्स्ट पार्ट है वो भी कंप्लीट ऑर्गेनिज्म बनाएगा. जो सेकंड पार्ट है दैट विल आल्सो गिव राइज टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बोथ द पार्ट्स एंड द कंप्लीट ऑर्गेनिज्म विल डेवलप एंड द थर्ड पार्ट विल आल्सो डेवलप द अदर टू पार्ट्स. सो दैट मींस वी कैन से इफ दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री फ्रैगमेंट्स देन थ्री फ्रैगमेंट्स गिव राइज टू द थ्री डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिजम्स. ओके, एंड द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन बाय द गैमेट फॉर्मेशन एज वी स्टडीड आल्सो द एग एंड द स्पर्म फॉर्मेशन. ओके, here fertilization is internal, that means the fusion of gametes will occur inside the body, and development is indirect. Now what is the meaning of development is indirect? If from the zygote the complete organism develop, then that is named as development is direct. But if after fusion there is a larva, pupa, these type of stages, and after those stages adult develop, this type of development is named as indirect development. An example is cycan and spongin. So that's all about the porifera. In the next class we will study about the other phyla.